The first thing to know about OpenStreetMap is that it doesn't use that. Nothing simple. So OpenStreetMap was developed 11 years ago by a computer science student. Its data model clearly shows that it was made by a programmer who knew nothing about simple physics. So the data model is quite simple. There are points with coordinates. There are lights which don't have geometry in them, they just built on points, and the relations that group points, ways, and other relations together. So it's quite simple on the outside, but when you start using it, it's not as such. And it's most topological, because things share same nodes, same ways sometimes, but it also isn't. So and all the data is basically implanted into a big interdependent ball of stuff. Yeah, and there are also tags. Tags like key value pairs, like amenity restaurant for a restaurant. And to draw a map, we must know what each tag means. And it's not as easy as it sounds, because there is no comprehensive list of tags anywhere in the OpenStreetMap. It's just in the wiki there are thousands of pages with a list of tags, some of which are quite long. It's just one chance, I think, of a complete page. I had to cut it because it was 1 pixel length otherwise. Yeah. And of course, people invent their own tags. Most people don't document what they do. Sometimes tags don't mean what you think they mean. So it's very complex. And you must know all of that to successfully edit all the steeper. Yeah, but on the outside, it's quite simple question. Yeah, so I'm going to talk about editors. That is software to change your names, add restaurants and shops, edit road geometry, and even manage public transport routes. There are popular editors in OpenStreetMap. Top three are desktop. So one of the best ones is JOSM, which can be called MVP for OpenStreetMap, because when you start it, you are presented with a black screen. There are editing modes like selection, join, and you have to remember which is which. And there are thousands of shortcuts. You can do almost anything. There is scripting. So it's quite powerful editor, but when users see it, they quickly close it and run something more simple, like ID. ID is a web-based editor. It's a modern, written in JavaScript. It basically leads the user by a hand. So if you want to draw a line, you just press a button that says draw a line. To make it a road, you click a button with a road in it. There are some other options. So on the outside, it's very simple, and most of the time it is. The problem with it is it tries to hide some concepts of OpenStreetMap. So sometimes the abstraction starts leaking and users start breaking relations. They use wrong text and they have no way of knowing it. And while JOSM has a very complex validation, so when you edit something, it will present a window with hundreds of errors that you made during that same session. ID does nothing of that, it just says what you did and doesn't inform anything. What is the beauty of symbol? But one important thing about OpenStreetMap is that it started not as a project to trace satellite imagery, because 11 years ago there were no suitable imagery layers at all, just landsat, which we don't want to trace. So OpenStreetMap was born as a project to gather data collected on the street. That means GPS traces, nodes, photos of shops and other amenities. So it was, by nature, it's a project collecting field data. And on satellite imagery, you can only see so much, some contours of buildings and all that, but no addresses, no shops, no street names. So really, to make the best map, you should go out and collect data. And there is a problem with most popular editors that you can't really use them on the field, because you then have to take the laptop with you, and it's not safe. You can lose your laptop, you can lose your internet connection, or lose your mind trying to use an editor in the middle of the road, trying to do your own thing. But of course, now everyone has mobile phones, and there are a lot of apps for mobile phones to edit and view OpenStreetMap. Right, so now I'll try to show you some of such apps. I always wanted to try displaying phone screen. From its name, it's OpenStreetMap for Android. It looks like this. So here's a map, well, conventional map, you all know what it is. But you can navigate, search for things. I didn't try it before. Yeah. And you can even use it as an editor, but it's not simple. There is no editing buttons anywhere. You have to go to menu, scroll it, miss some text, select plugins, find SM editing, and enable. Yeah, now yes, SM editing. And now you can easily add a point, just long tap, menu, create, and go.
What's the memo?
Yeah, it's really cool, yeah. So, the problem, one of the problems is you have to find in this list what you want. Party of this. Yeah. And when you connect to Wi-Fi, you can upload it. 18 points of interest is a bit harder, because you will miss the point. I missed it. So you have to search the list, yeah, library parameters, and then you can modify it. So, yeah, here's the address. Yes.
So what's the name of the application?
It's OSMAND, OSMAND. Yeah. I don't recommend it for editing, but it's quite good for those in.
Can you edit ways with OSMAND or only points?
No, it's
points.
Only points, and even not these points of interest that are taped on ways. Well, it's very simple, because it's not an full-fledged editor. And for example, Vespucci is this software called Vespucci. It also displays a map, but as you can see, it looks like an editor. So I've downloaded some data and some raster tiles on the ground. And this shows very important concept of a mobile editor that you take with you on the street. It has to have a good caching system. So you can see it has. So many users can afford mobile internet on the street. And in some countries, you don't have it. So you have to, at home, to download all the data, then go out and modify it. And that's why caching is very important.
What was the name of the program again?
Vespucci.
Can you do the same demo?
we'll try. First, it won't pull out anything because you have to enable edit. And this became quite dirty, so let's try to change our building. We have to choose our building. I think it's our way. Nothing happens. Here too. So this is text. So it's quite complex. I don't understand anything. I press some button. Okay, we can specify building level. So it's not good. You have many buttons that you don't know what they mean. I don't know. but it's edit. To everything, just long tap and there's new. And I'm lost. It's very good editor, but for people who know what they're doing, for example, for developers or
for people.
Sorry?
That's just for mobile.
Many people call it just like this. So it's has many features, but it's quite complex. So there's an alternative for iOS. I will show some iOS application, but I don't have iPhone on me, so just screenshots. The application is called GoMap. For some reason, with two exclamation marks. It looks like web editors, like I did actually. So you just zoom part of map. The data from OpenStreetMap is immediately downloaded, which means that you have a persistent internet connection on the street. Not good, but you can easily tap in things and understand what happens. So it's pre-assigned. Buttons are not icons, but text. And another important concept is shifted move point. So when you move a building, your finger doesn't obstruct where it stands. I wonder why viewers understand it. It also can allow for 18 tags. If you don't know what tags mean, you can have user tracing system. So it's quite so obvious what it is. There are two drawbacks to GoMap. One is that it's closed source. Well, OpenStreetMap doesn't require all applications that work with to be open, but it would be nice to do it. And the second thing is that it stores user passwords on the device, which is not secure. There are ways to do it. And there is no need to do that because OpenStreetMap API supports false authentication. Basically, direct user to a website, it returns a token, then you store it, and nothing happens if somebody steals it. There's another application, a contributor for Android, which is simple. It doesn't try to do everything like Vespucci and GoMap do. It's just an application for points of interest. It displays a map, it even caches, and it has very simple interface. Just one button, plus, and you can click points of interest. It also has a lot of types. Well, let's try yeah. Racing color. Maybe. Okay. We just created a point of interest. Yeah. And you can download some data from OpenStreetMap to edit. So that's a simple editor just for editing points of interest. And by doing so few things, it excels at what it does, and the way mobile editors should work. Pushpin is an alternative for iOS. It also displays points, allows for the editing, and it as GoMap is slightly better than Vespucci, which means slightly better than OSM contributor, because it's more understandable user interface. It has descriptions for its field, it supports browse authorization, it follows most OSM guidelines. So it's really is quite good. Well, it still depends on the internet. And many OSM experienced users are using it. OSM Tracker and Keypad Maker are data collecting apps. They don't edit OpenStreetMap, but they are very efficient in collecting when data. For example, Keypad Maper is used for collecting addresses. They say you can, in an hour, you can collect more than 200 addresses just looking on the street. And just type 6 at left, house number 7 at right, and say it's very efficient. Yeah. But you have to process the result with this property. Right. What's wrong with all these editors? One thing, to use them, you have to download them. And for that, you have to know they exist. And this is a major problem, because some of the editors I show were downloaded less times than FOSDEM schedule. And why is that? Because people usually don't plan ahead, like I'm going to need a map, and if I encounter some errors, then I need to fix them, and for that I need to download a map. So regular people assume that the map is the application. They don't think it, if application allows editing map, then great. If not, then it's just a map that can be used. So basically, of all applications I've shown, it's only OSMAND who would work for the user. But as you see, it's quite complex. So I'm talking about Maps. Maps is another application for OpenStreetMap. It's quite good, it's pretty, it's really fast. And it works on both Android and well, it supports many features that navigation app should support. This is Maps. it can do searching, can do bookmarks. You can do routing, pedestrian and car routing. It has night modes, voice directions, has night modes. I see it already. and also it has 3D buildings. I found one nearby. This blue tower. It's very cool, but it has no use. And it's free, and in September we made an amazing move. We open sourced all of it, both Android and iOS version. We published them on GitHub. So there are no proprietary cores or parts, except some optional tracking libraries. So yeah, you can use it, build the customized version, adjust styles. Yeah, and we decided to add an editor to this application because the app is quite popular. It has 25 million downloads, around 7 million monthly active users. And we decided to view these users editing the FOSDEM. So it turned out not to be quite hard. Just we have for each item you see a card with some data. And we just have to add to this place to button and you can put a name, choose a street in which it is, and open house and stuff. So I think it's the best interface there is because I've tried to eight entrants, all that are popular. Yeah, and then you can save it. I should say this is early beta version, so most things don't work, but at least you can see what happens. It applies when you have Wi-Fi and you should be logged in. So I will talk about signing in later. But when you have Wi-Fi, because Maps is completely offline application. You just download the map and you go on the street and you forget about it. So uploading is a little bit. So as you noticed, the editor here doesn't look like other editors because, for example, it doesn't have an expert mode to edit all raw text. And then because we don't have that, the file format is highly optimized for size and rendering speed. And that's why we process all text to metadata. So when I upload it, there is a very complex merging process. So it's a very complex merging process because we have to see what changes did you make and what the data in OpenStreetMap looks like, and from there we calculate it. And another problem is we release our maps just monthly, and in that time people continue editing OpenStreetMap, and then there will be conflicts. So we also have to resolve them. And the conflicts usually is a big problem, but we decided, we decided to make it simpler. So basically we change only text that user changed, but her was the last human. But it's very complex operating problem. What about Wendell? It's a very serious issue in OpenStreetMap, but not as serious in Wikipedia, for example. So and when we release the editor, it will be even more serious. So how do we protect the project from it? We have come with a solution. It was very complex, very interesting. But finally, we decided to skip that and just allow users editing OpenStreetMap directly. It's actually a good thing because there is already vandalism on OpenStreetMap, and JOSM editor shouldn't. Well, you can do vandalism with any editor. this will lead to community making better validation tools and reverse it. So I think it's really. So for that we have to do signing in and registration of the form. And as you know, the map registration is plainly very regular. So you enter your email twice, then you receive confirmation later. But this breaks the mobile workflow completely because you have to enter email twice on a mobile phone. When you get email and you have to start email application, click a link, it opens the whole browser, then you go back to Apple and enter password, and this is very fun. So we started looking for alternatives. It turned out that when in your social accounts, you go on Facebook, you don't have to type email, don't have to come up with a password or confirm email. You just click a button, next, next, next. Okay, you're ready to go. There's some problem with using native SDKs for that, because every Android user already has Google account on their phone, we want to use it, but it's just for some discussion stuff. Yeah, then we finalized in 11 years of OpenStreetMap. It has gained more than 400,000 contributors. People who have touched at least one of my map. And we are releasing the editor in a month or so to about 7 million active users in monthly. And they will definitely want to change that to edit some spins. Register and some other methods and this will increase number of editors on the system and basically it will move it to new era where desktop papers are minority. So OpenStreetMap was started as a project to collect local knowledge, and this change we are making it to get out of the way. So, okay.